Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So friends, electrolytes are being divided into two parts. The first one is strong electrolyte, and which says that the electrolyte when dissolved in water completely dissociates into respective cation and anion in the aqueous form. For example, in this case, if I have considered an example like AB, which is an electrolyte, when dissolved in water gives A plus cation and B plus anion in aqueous form. So in this case, suppose if I take one mole of AB, then it will dissociate completely into one mole of cation and one mole of anion. So for example, if I consider NaCl is a compound, or NaCl when present in an aqueous solution, it dissociates completely into Na plus and Cl minus, that is sodium cation and chloride ion. In this case, the number of moles of sodium and sodium ion and number of moles of chloride ion that are produced in the aqueous solutions are same, because they have dissociated completely when dissolved in water. Similarly, it happens with copper sulfate also. Copper sulfate is also a very strong electrolyte, and it helps to passage of the electricity by completely dissociating. So it dissociates completely into Cu2 plus ion, and hence gives an anion like SO4 2 minus, sulfate ion anion. So these are the reason that when they dissociate completely, and because of that, the electricity produced during the flow of ions, that is the flow of cation and the flow of anion, helps to conduct the electricity more efficiently, and hence they are known as strong electrolytes, and because of which the redox reaction may occur very fast, or the redox reaction occurs in a very efficient way. So now let us talk about the second one, that is weak electrolytes. Weak electrolytes are nothing but the electrolytes when dissolved in water dissociates partially or incompletely into their respective cations and anions. In this case, suppose if I have dissolved one mole of AB in aqueous solution, then the number of moles of A, that is cation, and the number of moles of B, they might not be one, or they might not be equal, they might be less than one. So this will happen only if they have not dissociated completely, or they have dissociated partially, and because of which the current passed through this solution are not that much efficient as compared to the strong electrolytes. For example, if I would give you an example like acetic acid is a weak electrolyte, as well as we know that acetic acid is a weak acid. When it dissolves, or when it is dissociated in water, it dissociates in the form of acetate ion, that is CH3CO O- plus H+. This dissociation of the acetic acid is very weak, and hence they don't help a very conduction of electricity in a very efficient way, and hence they are known as weak electrolytes. And talking about the another example that I could take is NH4Cl. Even this NH4Cl dissociates into NH4 plus Cl minus ion. So they don't dissociate in a very 100%, or they don't dissociate completely, and hence because of that they do not conduct electricity very efficiently, and hence they are known as weak electrolytes. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have gotten very glimpse idea that what is electrolyte and what are the types of the electrolytes, and this strong and this weak electrolyte will be very much influential in the next future that we are going to learn about this topic. So thank you. And share this with your friends, and please don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.